All right, welcome back. Yes, indeed, we'll be focusing on Edo politics, and Anselm Mujeswa joins us. He is the PDP PDP governorship aspirant for the state. I was going to say chairman, but I know you'd understand why. You've been chairman of the party, you've been chairman of even the APC itself, so sometimes it's confusing on the head. Say, look, why are we pitching this now? But again, thank you for joining us on the program. So tell us, you've thrown your hat into the ring. I mean, you're going for this one. What kind of reaction are you getting having joined the race?
Yeah, good morning, Chamberlain. Thank you for having me here this morning. In the last few months, I've been going around consulting with the leadership of my party and some leaders of our society here in Edo. And the response has been very, very encouraging. Very, very encouraging in the sense that you know about the situation of our party here in Edo over some time now. And you also know that it is not the very best. But going around, I have gone around all the major participants or the major leaders involved in this situation. And I think we can find common ground.
Mm. But why do you think so? Because there's, several, quote, heavyweights joining the fray. And then there's talk about the governor also interested in getting his voice heard in the party. Then you hear party people saying, look, no aspirant should determine or try to tilt it in their way or the other. So it comes across to onlookers that, look, this tussle is not going to be as straightforward, even though you're optimistic it will be.
You know, the very nature of politics requires that things must be, people can take their positions, but in trying to find common ground, then there has to be some level of consensus. The governor, for instance, it is usual for a governor to have a favorable successor or an acceptable successor, but it's not exclusive to him. He will require the assistance of the leadership of the party to achieve that objective. You know, don't forget that this is politics. This is not an authoritarian system. Therefore, it is important that in seeking whatever you seek in politics, you need to persuade other interests. You need to negotiate with them. It's a give and take situation. And sooner or later, you find common ground. So I think the most important thing now is for all parties involved to consider the interest of the party upon which all of us stand. If the party goes down, we go down with it. So in doing that, we must be in a position to make sacrifice. So our attitude to the situation, I think, is the most important at this point in time.
So will you be willing to make the sacrifice if you're asked to? And what would the conditions be for you to do so?
I don't have to make sacrifice. I am going to be the instrument that will be used to get all parties together because I know all the major players. They are all my friends. I have spoken with them. I trust them and I believe they trust me. So I can be the one to midwife this process. There is distrust in the system.
Wow. So assuming the governor says Aswen is his man or he puts him forward while Olu holds down the LP ticket being from the south, and then probably the party will then be forced to queue behind Aswen because you know he will throw his weight, his political weight, behind whoever he chooses. Why do you think you will stand a chance if that were to play out?
Well, like I told you, the governor may have his preference, but he will only do or succeed if he has the cooperation of other major players within the party. I believe that the governor is in a vantage position. He has information from all sources, including intelligence reports. He should know by now whose chances are best. But I cannot speak for him. I have been in touch with him even before I started on this journey and during the period. He has never indicated to me that he has a preference. I am yet to see anybody who will tell you that His Excellency Governor Obaseki has told him expressly that this is the position. So I would rather not speculate. Rather, I look at my own chances. I have looked at the state. I believe that I can add value to whatever is ongoing at the moment. And I do recognize the fact that our problem is a political problem. It requires a politician with experience who also has the vision that is, you know, in agreement with the ongoing progress that Edo has made over time. So I believe very sincerely that this is when the time has come for me to make my contribution to the development of Edo State.
I really cannot help but just take a look at, you know, I'm looking at you and I'm wondering, this was a total grafting of the APC into the PDP. And I'm wondering, who is the PDP going to be competing against? And this is no, you know, this is no offense to the APC, and I hope they don't take any. But
No, not an offense. You have made a proper observation. If we handled ourselves well, we would have had a monumental success. Would have made a monumental success of our cooperation. You know, if you look at the election of 2020, the results, Edo has never had it like that. All we needed to do was to build upon it. But unfortunately, our leaders failed to agree on issues, and they are, in my opinion, deploying the wrong methods for resolution. Conflict, in my opinion, does not help political. You know, you can imagine what is going on in the judiciary. Everybody is blaming the judiciary. But if the politicians had managed themselves properly, if they had sought and obtained political solutions, then there would have been no need to go to the judiciary. This is one of those classical cases where handling of this issue is what, in my opinion, is important. It's imperative, really. If PDP must succeed in Edo State, people must learn to make sacrifice. They must shift their position. Let us meet at some point where we can all reach some level of agreement and trust, and then we begin to build up on it. Thankfully, there is enough time. Mm. You know, they say a day is a lifetime, you know, in the life of a politician.
Very true. A day is a lifetime indeed. But I'm really wondering whether those of you who came from the APC to the PDP in Edo State can make the demands that you're making of the PDP in that state. I know that now you can say that, well, we're bona fide members of the party, haven't delivered the governor. The governor has remained faithful to the party. He hasn't spoken about leaving, and he's been quite, let's say, forthright in terms of his dealings. But then you must also remember that there are people whom you met in that party, and I'm sure that they too would have wanted to take shots at the governorship position as well. Do you think that it is right that, you know, you ask that people should make sacrifices for those who were hitherto not within the party?
Well, you see, the situation we find ourselves is where the party has to make up its mind what will be in its best interest. Whatever decisions they have made in the past, I do not say it is sacrifice. I would say it is a step they took, knowing that that would be the best possible step in order to achieve the results that we want. What did we want? We wanted victory. God gave us victory. Today, we are in a very delicate situation. Now, you need to look at everybody, and then you pick your right person. Whether he is old, whether he is new, we are all PDP. So whatever we do must be determined by what is best, what is in the best interest of the party. What is in the best interest of the party? Who can you sell to the people of Edo at this point that they will accept from you and vote for? Who will enable you to win the election? Who has the experience? Who has the knowledge? And who has the skills? Who can manage all of us better? That is the question. Not a matter of where you come from, how you come from, or I don't think that is helpful.
It is interesting that you are talking about, you know, who the PDP can sell to the people of Edo State. I mean, only recently paying a visit to Edo and looking at the, will I say, the convivial relationship that seemed to be existing between the main political actors. I had the privilege of attending Alagodaro only recently, and I saw that, you know, all of the heavyweights in Edo politics were at, you know, that particular summit. And I was wondering, you know, if the primaries for the PDP in Edo State, or even the primaries of any political, well, I don't know how it's going to be in other political parties, but looking at all the political actors that are there, I'm wondering whether a consensus candidate, do you see the PDP going into primaries, or do you think that they most likely will adopt a consensus candidate? Because it does appear that this ticket is going to be very hotly contested. It appears to me, and I could be wrong, you can correct me if I am, if you don't agree, that whoever it is gets the ticket of the party will most likely, you know, it's almost like as if it's a done deal for that person in terms of becoming governor. Do you agree?
Well, you see, it is true. I was at Alagodaro myself, and I would say it was a very well-organized event, and I think that kudos should go to the governor and the organizers. Having said that, quite a number of political leaders were there, but I can tell you, quite a number were also not there. Those who ought to be there were not there. That is a worrying situation for those of us who are here. So those are the things we want to work on. Those are the things we want, an all-inclusive situation. You see, about consensus, consensus comes in various ways. It may not be 100%. If you make 60%, I think that's a fantastic result. But the point about it is this. This is not the first time we are confronted with a situation like this. All the elections we have had since 1999, we have had issues of multiple aspirants. It's not new. And when political leaders meet, it is not for public consumption. At those points where they reach consensus, each one goes to his various location and implements what they have all agreed. And that is the result, you know, of the exercise. Even the incumbent, His Excellency, when he contested, he had quite a number of people contesting with him from across the state. But when we reached a consensus amongst ourselves, we went to the stadium to implement it, and he emerged victorious. So there are ways and means that these issues are resolved. All it requires, number one, like I said, the right attitude. Number two, people must be willing to shift their positions. It's about persuasion, negotiation, and you arrive at a resolution. That is the key to this. You know, in Asian language, we say it is not the eye with which you eat pounded yam that you use to divide meat. So when you see politicians being convivial in, you know, social events, that is different when they want to make critical political decisions, you know. Then the cold one comes in, you know, and people have to be realistic. You know, the truth about it is all the efforts we are making is to enable us win the election in September 2024. And if you don't have a good product, then it's dead on arrival.
I certainly will keep that proverb in mind when next I see them shaking hands and back clapping themselves.
But yes.
Let's go
it's
to
an
Lagos.
Proverb.
Let's go to Lagos now. I know my colleagues have questions for you.
All right, thank you, Mark. I just want to quickly get your thoughts on what the governor said about the division, the issues within the PDP. For him, he believes that the division, the drama we've seen is not from within, but from outside players. I wonder if you agree with him on that one. If you do, then who is responsible for it, or who are the people responsible?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Right. I'll just repeat my question. I want to get your thoughts on what Governor Obaseki said just before we came to you about the issues, the conflict within the PDP in Edo State. He believes that it is caused by players or parties from outside and not necessarily people from within. Do you agree with him? If you do, then who are these people responsible? Why do they have so much influence within the PDP?
You know, unfortunately, I don't have the advantage of the information available to His Excellency, and therefore I may not be able to comment, you know, effectively on that. But you know, in politics, you can't discount any possibilities. But your ability to respond to it, you know, is what I think is important. So it is good that His Excellency is aware of that, and therefore he probably will know the steps to take to ensure that we are not divided. What is important to me is that should PDP go to election in a fractured form, the self-defeat has already started. Therefore, it is important that all of us must try to work together. Even those who may have left in anger, we must take steps to retrieve them. Because politics, as they say, is a game of numbers. You know, again, I have to fall back to my native language or proverb. They say we are not enough. We are still counting, you know, mad people. What we need to do is to ensure that we are able to accommodate ourselves. Let us look at our collective interest. Let us subsume our personal interest and look at the interest of the party that made us what we are. That is what is important. What do we need to do to ensure that PDP wins Edo State in September 2024? That should be at the back of everybody's mind, right from Mr. Governor down to the lowest party member in Edo State. That is my position.
Right. So does the governor have a say in who should become the candidate of the PDP come 2024?
I wish you could speak up, please.
Yes, I am. My question is, does the governor then, in your opinion, have a say in who becomes the candidate of the PDP come 2024?
But of course, the governor is a very critical component. As a matter of fact, the entire process will revolve around him. But, you know, like I said, he can't do it alone. He can't do it alone. He needs leadership. You know, no matter how, the only omnipotent being is God. All of us have limitations. You know, if I need something as a governor, then I will identify leaders across the state and I will romance with them. I will interface with them. I will interact, you know, until everybody, you know, gets involved, or at least most people. That has been the culture, and is a tradition. You cannot, Chief Abiola said, you can't shape people's heads, you know, in their absence. And again, let me even say this: if the governor is aware that there are some set of people that will not be acceptable, it is in his own self-interest to ensure that in carrying out this exercise, he takes it in mind that there are no areas, so that we don't even have problems before we even start the journey.
So, Mr. Jeswa,
he has to be sensitive to the feelings of everybody.
Right. So my question is...
That is why he's the leader.
Okay, I'll come to your political background and why you think you're fit for this job. But a quick follow-up to that then is, what are you exactly angling for? As you said, politicians are a very interesting set of people. So, I mean, you might expect them to do this and they're actually, you know, aiming for another thing. Some would say you declaring for governor at this time is just for you to have a bargaining chip. Such that, well, you aim for the moon. If you miss it, you fall amongst the clouds and what have you. So what exactly are you angling for? Is it governorship or nothing for you? Or you might be able to settle for a political solution to this if the governor is willing?
Anybody who is familiar with my development in politics should tell you that arguably I may not be the oldest in age, but in terms of experience, I am one of the oldest politicians in Edo State, having been there since 1982. I have had the benefit of serving in various governments in this state, in various capacities as well. And therefore, you may say, I have seen it all. To suggest that at this my age and with my experience, that I will be coming here just to see what I can get out of the process, I think is a bit, unlike me. What I can tell you, I have looked at Edo State. I traced our history. If you listen to my declaratory speech, this problem did not start with Obaseki. Let nobody situate it on his table. It started from 1999, precisely from 2003 to date. We have had successive political issues amongst our major political leaders, which has affected everybody in the state. And it has become a recurrent decimal. I have looked at it. I have studied it. And I know where the solutions are. And that is one of the major reasons why I have offered myself. In addition to that, in spite of all the efforts we have made, even as a nation, Nigeria is not in production. And even if we are in production, we are not in processing, not to talk of manufacturing. If we don't deepen our economy, there is no way we can get out of this mess that we have found ourselves. I also have solutions to deepen the economy of Edo State and perhaps join others to give an example that Nigeria should follow. So I have the knowledge, I have the ability, I also have the vision. I am going to also take advantage, if you know, the current governor has in his own wisdom created a roadmap for 30 years. It is just for us to sit back, follow it, and make amendments as we move on. If there are other areas that we feel we can, add value, of course we will do so. I have spoken about so many things. If you look at the attitude of public servants to citizens, you will not call them servants. They behave like masters. Sometimes some of us, we feel that we can come and talk to our people to say, look, these citizens are our masters. Let us treat them as such. Let's treat them in a humane manner, even if we don't want to be their servants. But at least let us treat our citizens with respect. Secondly, there's this sore issue of land acquisition by state. I think that there are, improvements that we can make in the process, involve the community in the land administration system, so that we can have a conducive atmosphere, so that investors can even have the confidence to come in and feel safe in Edo. There are so many things that we can do. I think the main word there is attitude, following which, experience. Next to that, skills. Our problem in Edo today is not, look, this same Obaseki that you see people, talking about. It is the citizens that gave him the name Wake and See, arising from his activities in government. He has not changed, but his rating has changed. Why? Politics. We need to deploy political skills to get out of this morass.
Besides all of these programs that you have enumerated, Mr. Jezua, what about the federal roads in Edo State? What plans would you have to ensure that there's a partnership between the state and the federal government to get it done? And do you have any reservations about the disposition of the incumbent so far, in making demands of for the federal government to, ensure to bring attention to speak to the roads? Because the deputy governor hinted at the sour relationship, so to speak, between the state and the federal government and how it has impacted on the delay in getting those roads rehabilitated.
Well, under the constitution of our country, the primary purpose of government is the welfare and security of its citizens. Having said that, in the past, we have had situations where state has intervened in situations of federal roads going back. It got to a point, I think the federal government asked the states not to get involved anymore because they will not get refunded. And you know, these are huge funds. But I think there was a time some parts of our state, namely Ekpo, my area, and Sapley Road here in Benin, we had a terrible situation. The communities even started coming out and all that. And the governor went to try and do some intervention. He was told clearly that he must move out of sight. That the federal government has already given out a contract, you know, for these jobs. And he had no option but to move. You know, but no sooner than he left, the road was abandoned. It is even worse now than it was before. But now this is a new administration. The minister, I watched him, he has made a statement that he is willing to, you know, cooperate with the state. I will take him on his words. We will not only meet with the federal government, even the contractor must be part of that that effort. So that if we put in an investment, then the contractor must be willing to sign a domiciliation agreement such that when federal government is paying, they pay to us that which is due to us. I think that is one way we can resolve it. The attitude, in my opinion, is good so far. The minister has made his point. It is for us to reciprocate. Having regards to the relationship with the between the federal government and the state, this is what happens when we do not stop playing politics. When a government is elected, politics ought to stop and governance ought to take over. When issues of governance take precedence, the issue of which side of the divide you belong will not arise. We are looking at what is in the best interest of our citizens. If I become governor, whosoever it is that is in the federal government will receive my full cooperation in order that our citizens can get the best possible results.
Well, there are still several steps to take ahead of that time when even the primaries will hold within the party. But as expected, the deputy governor was also bullish about his chances of securing the ticket. So do you think you can beat him for that ticket, as it were?
From my findings, I think I can.
Okay, so tell us one more thing. I mean, we see today that there are reports of a fresh crisis hitting the PDP because there's this legacy group who say they walked out of a meeting of the council meeting that was called, executive council meeting that was called on Wednesday, saying that they are protesting, they don't want, oppose the governor picking a candidate or imposing a candidate for the party. What's going on with that?
Well, I think it's part of what I'll be telling you. Why do they say that? I have also told you, the governor has not made a statement. He's being suspected. Can we dwell on speculations? I think the answer is no. But I think that a political solution can be effected. All parties must be approached so that we can get the right results. I still believe that there is a way out. Honestly, I do.
Do you think that if the governor has a candidate in mind, do you think it is imperative for him to say so now?
Oh, sure. You know, politics is not a secret society. You must tell somebody. Otherwise, how will he relay your message? And if your message is not related, then the beneficiary will gain nothing. At the same time, the governor is also obliged to get feedback. He can sound out some of his trusted political leaders, some of his trusted political aides, those of them who have the courage to tell him to his face what the world is on the street. Because whatever we do, we are all going back to the streets to get endorsement. When the governor was a victim of this, of the high-handedness, it was the people in the street that saved him. Nothing else. If it was about money, power, and the rest, we had lost. But the people of Edo, they say, they will not accept. So we must be mindful how we handle. This issue is an issue that needs a lot of wisdom, a lot of tact, and our attitude must be the right attitude.
I'm a little concerned about the fact, I mean, as you said, you are one of the most experienced politicians in the state. You've been in this game for a very long time. You have always played the role of a conciliator. And some people will say, oh, look, you've thrown your hat in the ring as well. You who have always served as this conciliator and this calming factor. How are people accepting this, especially now that it does appear that these skills which you have shown over the years will now are most needed?
You have hit the nail on the head. If you adopt me, I am in a position to reach all sides. They will trust me because we have known ourselves for a long time. I have maintained my friendships. This is the time I will reap from my goodwill. It's more valuable than money.
When you are taking the very thing which they desire, I mean, usually kingmakers are one step ahead or one step higher, elevated, and those who desire to be king, at least when you are still seeking to be that king, until at least they eventually get to that position. Do you think that they would listen to you when you are now in the same ring desiring what it is that they too desire?
Yeah, but that is what politics is about. It's about negotiation. It's about persuasion. Nothing is off the table. It's about who can we put up that can win for us?
All right.
What product can we, who has credibility with the people? Who has integrity? Who can we push forward that will attract even interest in other parties? That is what we need now. That's what we need. And that's why I said we must subsume our personal interest so that our collective interest can be sustained. The party, like they say, is supreme. Let us act in the interest of our party. I believe very sincerely, if I believed that there was somebody more qualified than myself at this point in time, I would easily just say, this man is there, let him do it. Because you see, everybody who has come out has his own small nest. I am the only one who is acceptable to all. And I say this very modestly. I don't mean to be arrogant. It's not in my character.
All right, still many rivers to cross. So let me not hypothesize about what may likely happen, because you will say that, well, he has not said he was going to do anything yet. So people shouldn't react based on that. But they are politicians, so they hear things. And so, but who knows? Well, we'll keep our tabs on this and look to bring everyone back in the days ahead. But in the meantime, thank you for coming on this morning and all the best to you.
Oh, thank you for having me. Thank you so much.
All right. We will be back in a moment. Join us again.